The Europeans over on you.
Hey, Meps is in the chat.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, Meps. How are you doing?
Right.
Wow, we, that just happened.
Yeah, this is borderline embarrassing.
Sorry.
Should we get this party started?
Yeah, let's do it.
Right, I'm going to roll the intro then.
All that beautiful bean footage.
Welcome. Yum, yum.
To a DC Universe online podcast. Bringing you news. And weekly entertainment. For the DCUO People's Podcast.
Okay, we are live. Off you guys see if you can
What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of the DCUO People's Podcast. That's right. That's a bunch of us get together here, either on my stream or on Orbit stream, and we sit down, we talk about the game and what's going on in it with the players in the community and what we got coming up in the future. I am, of course, Super Patriot, coming to you live here from the U.S. PlayStation side. Sitting across from me is the player number one on the EU PlayStation side, Mr. Orbit.
Yo, everybody in the street. How you doing?
And sitting here also with us today is rank undetermined Aphrodite, also from the EU PlayStation.
What? That's not a very nice intro. Excuse me.
Where did that come from?
Rank undetermined. Rank. Well, I mean, how many DCU videos have you put up on your channel?
None. I'm planning it though. I got a few more videos on my channel. Give me a break.
How is your channel going, Aphrodite? You enjoying it?
Yeah, it's all right. We've made our own server on Minecraft as well now.
You can make your own server?
Yes, you can. All you need is either Hamachi login, or you could just have to write the codes yourself, basically.
Oh my god!
That's amazing!
Where do I sign up for Minecraft?
Go on my channel, subscribe, and I'll send you all the links you need. Yeah.
There we go.
Anyway.
Another news. No, so how have you two been this week? What have you been up to?
I tested out the new Earth update. Day one of the Earth update there. I took my Earth-tuned Patriot girl in to tank the Tier 6 alert. Live-streamed it. I don't know if you stopped by and checked that out or not.
Yeah, I did see that. Yep.
Yeah. Did you see some of the shenanigans our friend Meps did?
Yes, he is a little rascal. That was
epic. It was so epic, though, because it reminded me, I've said this before, but it reminded me of that Superman-Batman Apocalypse animated movie.
Yeah.
You know, when Darkseid, what is it, Doomsday is on the Themyscira to fight the Amazons. It was pretty epic. I, however, have coined a new phrase for that. All right, that wasn't Darkseid. That was Mepseid, and he was stoon tubing. He stoon tubed those Doomsdays in there. All right. I don't know if you guys haven't been watching FNL, have you?
No.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, no, I've been flicking on, like, you know. It's late for us.
I know. Well, I mean, they do the replays on YouTube, though.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
But no, Yen started up his new name for Meps on FNL and all that. He calls him Teed Stoon.
I did actually see that. I didn't quite understand it.
Yeah, it's all over the place now.
Ted Stoon.
Teed Stoon.
Really nice name.
That's an OP name.
Hope you hear my sarcasm.
Epps is upset you're not watching his live stream, but he's here watching ours.
Is he really? Why did you put your link in the chat and see if it gets deleted again?
Wow!
No, that link, was no rude. Links allowed.
See how much the See how much the EU loves you, Meps? Right? You see how much the EU loves you?
No links allowed.
Wow.
Thanks.
But yeah, it was pretty epic seeing all those Doomsday spawn, just flying in over them when, you know, I did when that happened. The whole just seeing them all there. I mean, I a couple of drops of pee came out the first one I saw them, and then I started hitting them, and they just, you know, we started attacking them, and they all just started melting away. I think that was like an alpha build NPC that he spawned in there. but it was pretty epic.
So yeah, I mean, you know, you said we did that on the EU server a couple of weeks ago, where he spawned, you know, some things into the watchtower and stuff. And I think it'd be, I said this on a couple of podcasts ago, it'd be great if they actually had something daily, like something just thrown in open world or in the watchtower or an invasion, where, because I mean, it's so fun, isn't it? It's just different.
Well, I mean, a lot of other games, everyone knows, they have like guides programs where, or, you know, they'll, I don't know if it's like, if it's actually, you know, they give power to some players in the game, you know, certain powers they pick, or if they like hire on, or if it's a dev that every once in a while will go into the game, like at scheduled times or anything like that throughout the day, and will spawn in, like, you know, like, oh, the avatar of tech is, you know, attacking, you know, Little Bohemia. You know, and stuff like that.
Orbit, you know, so I mean, you're really low. Just saying
stuff like that.
Yeah,
stuff like
just
that.
Trying to just
fix trying it.
To, yeah, but I'm not 100% sure how. So bear with me. Yeah, well, carry on, super.
Like I said, though, it was really cool seeing that, you know, spawning and everything like that. I mean, I would really like to see them do something like that in DCUO, where, you know, they can, you know, I mean, dude, I would have a blast doing that. I mean, I would spend. I mean, I'm sure they'd have some controls on it, because you can't let, you know, all players just run wild on the game. You know, I mean, spawn in, you know, like, you know, 20, you know, freaking. The Batmans, the Nexus Batmans, in all of Doom, I would have a blast doing that, but that would be kind of griefing after a while. Something like that. Just, you know, every once in a while, you know, so, you know, and, you know, you know, players and all that, you know, maybe get something out of it. You know, it's like, you know, like, you know, like if it's cybernetic Lex and all that, you know, every player that beat him gets, you know, his shield style. Or whatever, you know what I'm saying? That would be really cool. You know, if it's Space Lex, you know, everybody gets his helmet. That would be really cool. Yes. Just stuff like that.
It would be cool.
But those epic fights, man, those epic fights are for the win. I was actually on the other day, and I didn't have any of my recording gear set up when it happened, but Meps was in the watchtower, and he started off by spawning in. I want to say it was some scarecrows. We spawned in a bunch of scarecrows, and it was like a back and forth battle with the scarecrows. And the next thing we know, he's down in the war room, and there had to have been at least 100 razors down there. You know, those Batman, those Bane minions and everything.
Yeah.
There had to have been about 100 razors down there. In the war room, just all over the. I mean, he like littered the floor with them, and I think Bane was down there too. And those things were hitting so hard. And I ended up, I had to turn off my UI because the screen was like, the frame rate on the screen was so bad. Everything was in. I was like, oh my god, it was a lot of fun.
Paz DCO said he would like to be spawned in the Hall of Doom with a full raid group and see how long you can last.
I know, man. I know. That kind of stuff would be awesome. Kind of stuff would be awesome to be able to do. I mean, yeah, I mean, the, you know, but, you know, they do have this survival mode now. It's for PvE that the that's on the test server right now. Did you guys seen any videos about that yet?
Yeah. It looks awesome.
I flicked on a few videos, but to watch through a whole round...
Oh my god. Well, I know some guys from the community council got together and
Who are the Community Council? Is that a league?
No. Community Council is the SOE Community Council that I'm on.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I know what you're talking about.
some players from the SOE Community Council got on a test server with some other players that were on a test, and they got up to round almost. I think they got up to or almost got to round 7, which was
pretty cool. Get to round 7. I'm sure I saw something about someone going up to round 7 already.
Yeah, that was the guys from the
Community Council. Was that them? Oh, okay.
Yeah, I actually got farther than Odyssey did, which, you know, caused some major stirs up on the forums, apparently. But Bess is here, messaging me here, wanting me to talk about, they're doing a special preview, a Game Update 38 preview live stream tomorrow at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time.
Okay.
Where they're going to be talking about, first of all, it's the Batman's 75th birthday, I guess. They're going to be talking about that and celebrating that. They're going to show off the new Batman Legends skin, which I'm sure our little buddy Balkan would be happy to see. And
someone's trying to wind you up in the chat.
Oh, my God. Steel Genesis. Yeah, so... I'll get to that in a minute. Yeah, it's going to have, the global brand manager, Eric Buzzword Duncan, is going to be there. And obviously, Teed Mepstoon will be on the stream as well, posting that. But it's going to be on their live stream on DCO's Twitch live stream channel at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. That's 7 p.m. Eastern here in the U.S. And I believe that's, it's going to be around midnight for you guys over there in the U.K.
Yeah, normally is. by the way, is my mic a little bit better now?
Yeah, it's a lot better.
Is it?
Well, you are louder to me.
Yeah.
Nobody said anything.
I boost my mic up a little bit. Hopefully that's better. Anyway, going back to the Community Council going to round 7, I think I remember Meps saying that they'd be surprised if we got to round 5, was it?
Well, I know there's different rewards that you get for getting to certain rounds. I think round 4 you get like this shirt or something like that. I can't remember. It's on the forums. You get like a special it's just a cosmetic style. There's like no stats on it or anything like that. But you get, you get different cosmetic styles for each, tier of rounds that you achieve in. So like I think like the bronze is like round 4, I believe, and then round 6 or you got something else. That's the silver and all that. Nobody's gotten the gold yet, from as far as I know.
What I am not a fan of, and Meps, you're in the chat so you can listen, is the styles seem a little bit similar, just different colours.
You mean the newer tier styles?
The survival styles.
They
all look pretty much the same, just looks like the same. Just different colours. And one of them you can actually change the colours. So, to me, I don't know. It's okay to have it as one of the rounds, but a different colour through, like, several rounds? I don't know. What do you think on that?
Get me as a outfit creator. I'm very
creative. You're not an outfit creator at all.
I'll draw Orbit a kind of like bikini, and I'll fit it to his like slim body with like cosmic arms or something.
Meps is in the chat here. He says they're the same style, but they have different metals on them.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I don't know. I'm not a fan, Meps. I'm sorry. I wanted different styles. I wanted like a hugely different.
See, what would be really cool is I'm not really dissing on the styles or anything like that, because I mean obviously they're unique, but what would be really cool is like some, like iconic styles that came off of those bosses themselves. It's like, you beat You beat who all is in there? You beat Guy Gardner. You know, you beat Red Guy Gardner, right? you get Red Guy Gardner's chest style. That would
That's
be
a
cool.
Nice chest.
Yeah. I'm definitely for, you know, if you've got a chest there, you defeat them and you get like a unique style through what that part of them. What's a good example of that?
Yeah, Meps is in the chat too. He's wanting to say that. It's important to remember this is a prototype, and they didn't plan any style rewards. They whipped up some based on feedback, which is cool. I mean, like we said, you know, this is everybody needs to remember this is on the test server, so things are subject to change whenever before everything goes live.
The a good example of that is the flash. That noise has come back again. Super.
It's not me, man. I have not done anything different.
Okay. well, that Flash duo where you got to take down Abra and you get Abracadabra's chest as a rare style, like that's more of that. Definitely more of that.
I'm missing the iconics. Some of them, and all that. I mean, they've talked about. It's like, you know, I've always like ever since the they made Wonder Woman use the shield now instead of martial arts. I've wanted that shield style for my tune, for my main. You know, and. I know, I'm probably never going to get... They said there were some licensing issues there. But they said the same thing about the green aura. So, we've got the green aura in the game now.
Yeah, that's true, but I think they can pass the green aura as something else. I mean, but the Wonder Woman emblem on the shield, I don't know.
I like the Wonder Woman emblem.
Yeah, I like it as well. I just don't know very if fitting. They would be able to do that.
Potential problem with iconic styles is that people will really want them, all people, not just the diehard crazy people who can survive survival mode.
Wow, you are terrible at reading.
Do you want me to put more effort into it when I read?
Yes, please.
Okay, someone
just one whole sentence.
Tribotic game. Hey, SB, what do you think about having dragon gear? We have dragon gear?
Dragon gear. Like dragon stylized gear? I mean,
probably sure, style. You know. He was talking about dragon style before, I think. But anyways, here's another question. What is your reaction to Effany quitting? I know SP is very upset about that one.
Yeah,
why
I am.
Why are you speaking in a sexual voice?
That's me putting more effort into it.
No, that's you sexualizing it.
Fine.
That's you trying to make all these kids in the chat horny. All right, knock that off.
Well, those kids shouldn't be on DC then, should they? Just saying. No, but yeah. What do you guys think about Effany?
I hate seeing anybody, you know, like Effany or Sarah.
Yeah.
I hate seeing anybody leave the game. I really do hope they come back.
Well, I'm pretty sure Sarah's got a new job, and she's moving, I think. So she's got some stuff in real life to do. I think she'll come back when she's settled down.
She'll be back on. She can't last long without DC. She was on today.
That's not her. That's her nephew.
Okay. Yeah, she'll be back on. Once she's settled in to where she's moving to, she'll be back on, I guess.
Yeah, and it's a shame about Effany as well. I'd like to think she'd come back, but we'll have to see.
All right, so
now me and Zeta are the only girls in the league.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you, but real quick, there's a question in the chat. All right, Meps has a question. All right, and his question is, Meps, how long will Survival Mastery on OA last? So now we sit here and we wait 30 seconds for the chat to catch up. We can hear Meps' answer.
Say he's asking himself a question? I'm very confused.
No, he's trolling us because we stopped talking to him for a minute.
Please, if he wants to join in that badly, maybe he should join the call.
Yeah, super.
I asked him. I think he's busy over there. I think he's like multitasking right now.
He's not busy. If he was busy, he would be right in the chat and be upset if we don't talk about it.
He's more involved with the chat than we are.
Yeah. But we're actually talking to the chat.
Super Patriot, do a British accent. Go on.
Oh, God. You don't want that.
Go on, try it.
Looky here. You don't want me to do any British accent. Because I'm
that, that, that just yeah. sounds like a Southern American accent again. That's not British.
Awful. I know.
This is British. Oh, I can't even do British accent, I don't think. Who was smoking? Not me.
Well, back to DC Universe. Yeah, back to, which is what we are supposed to be talking about. Earth. What do you think of Earth now after the update, after you've had a chance to go through...
Meps answer the question real quick.
No, I was quoting someone else.
But I mean,
He says it will rotate with each other and in and out. So we don't have any details set. Wow, thank you for that wealth of information from that answer. There, Meps. Why do I not have the sharp shoelace? Because Meps won't give them to me. All right, there you go. There it is.
You do not deserve it.
I guess not. I actually have a league mate of mine who has like 6 tunes. He made a video showing off all 6 of his tunes in the full sharpshooter style.
That's really nice of him. Yeah. Did you kick him from your league?
I almost made a video myself of me kicking every single one of his tunes out of the league. I was like, who's? Yeah, I was gonna title it. Who's the best sharpshooter now?
I will pay you to do that video. So yeah, answer my question. Jeez, how long does a brother need to wait?
Earth question? I'm actually want to ask you. I mean, how do you feel about it? I mean, you are the Earth Master.
Thank you. The Earth Master. I don't know what to say. Okay. Yeah, I love it. I really, really like it. I love it. It's like 10. It's so much better. So much better.
What's so much better about it?
The DPSing just flows really nicely now. From, you know, the rumble crash is really nice. Just everything's so smooth and there's plenty of damage. It goes well with your weapon mastery. I don't like the crystal DPSing as much as a normal loadout.
Well, with the crystal out, don't you lose out on the percentage bonus for weapon mastery?
Apparently so, yeah.
Yeah.
But the main reason I don't like it is because the crystal damage comes up in like a dark red and you can't really see it right there. So it's almost like it's not, like you don't see as much popping up on your screen as the other loadouts. I tell you what I don't like, though, is scrimmaging in tank stance as much as what it was before. Mainly because of Pebble Blast. It hasn't got as good burst damage with the Pebble Blast as what it
is. I saw that the first day of the update. Everybody's like, you know, screaming about Pebble Blast in our Bobby Five chat over here. And they're like, oh, Earth's ruined because of Pebble Blast. They changed Pebble Blast. And I'm like, okay, one power. Just to completely annihilate it, a completely regen power.
What I don't understand, though, is they've got stone, which is at the top of the tree, and that is a single target daze. And then you've got Pebble Blast, is also a single target daze now. That's what I don't understand about it.
It's not Conus power anymore?
No, it doesn't. You don't benefit anything from them being daze. It's just that it dazes them now. And it's about the same cast time. It's just, I don't know why they'd had to change that, to be honest. I'd like that to be changed back to benefit from them being dazed. But apart from that, I love it. I'm having so much fun.
Are you tanking with Brick?
Yes.
Are you?
Yeah.
What's your loadout that you use for tanking? I saw you upload a DPS for PvP video.
I did my tanking one as well. Catch up.
I haven't seen that. Easy now.
How rude.
I've always used Earthen Grip and Epicenter to control the enemies, to keep aggro, not to keep aggro, to pull them in and
right.
pull them in nice and tight. I use those two. Like you said, though, in one of your videos, it would be nice if the Earthen Grip was multiple target.
Yeah, and it'd be nice too if the cooldown was shorter.
Yeah. I actually, on my video, I'm doing like a little, like a demo, like it's hard to, when you, have you found that when you're demonstrating a tank, you can't really demonstrate a tank, like in front of a dummy. So I was trying to like simulate it, and I was like, right, so imagine, right, we've got some enemies, and Epicenter, drag them all in, and then I did Earthen, like turned myself around, Earthen Grip, drag that person in, right, another Epicenter, and then I was like, right, turn around, drag another guy from over there, and it's still on cooldown. I was like, oh, might need to do another Epicenter there.
and that's the thing that was that's the one thing that frustrates me the most about Earth tanking is the fact that, you know, Earthen Grip is the cooldown on it so long, and it's only a single target. Granted, it's, you know, it's not as bad as, you know, Fire's situation. You know, Fire doesn't have a long range pull like that. At all. But, you know, at least with Earthen Grip, you know, it'd be nice to be able to pull in multiple targets. It'd be nice if it worked like Ragebringer and Escapable Storm did.
Yeah.
Rice. Ragebringer, I've, like, grabbed hold of, like, five freaking ads sometimes and yanked them right to me. Yeah, it's awesome.
Doesn't Rage and, have, a like, a close-range pull as well? Like an AoE pull as well?
Yeah.
I don't understand either.
Yeah, so I mean, so being able to pull in multiple ads, especially when you're fighting, you know, like you know, a huge group of ads too. Because I don't know about you, but I mean, it's like, especially when I'm, you know, doing rage, because it's so much easier. I'll, like, you know, go into an area and, like, you know, like that opening spot in Themyscira, that Themyscira alert. I like to go and, like, land in, like, in the middle, in between groups of ads, and then pull them all aggro them all on top of me.
Yeah.
So it's It is a bit frustrating that, you know, Earthen Grip's like that. What else you got in your loadout, though? You under Earthen Grip?
Yeah, then I've got the new immunity breakout, the one that heals you.
Soothing Sands?
Yeah, that's the
Soothing thing. Sands, yeah.
I use that mainly for, like, emergencies when I'm being knocked over, or, you know, sometimes to clip with, depending how fast I need to get through my moves.
Right.
Then I'm using, obviously, Brick and Fortified Golem.
Mm-hmm.
And then I use Totem, sometimes Gemstone Shield instead of Totem. And there's my loadout. And it works really well, and it's easy. Like, because now you've got your Brick up, and you've always got that damage absorption. You just need to focus on rounding up the ads, pretty much, just throwing out the Fortified Golem whenever that comes off cooldown. So it's actually quite an easy tank and power now. Which is good. You want tank and powers to be easy.
Yeah, you don't want to be too hard to...
Yeah, you don't want to be thinking about all this kind of stuff. You want to just fucking, do that.
Yeah, that's about the same loadout I've got. I really like it. It's definitely... better than what it used to be, especially with the you know, using Brick and everything.
That's not very nice.
Aphrodite, what are you opening? Like a packet of sweets or something?
Cookies.
That's so inappropriate.
I like my cookies.
Okay. You have to open them in everybody's ear.
I know.
To make everybody jealous. That's why.
Out of interest, what cookies have you got?
Whole grain cookies with chocolate. Oh shit! Sorry.
So, how about you? Like, what about what the DP? Have you tried the DPS in yet, Super?
I haven't tried the DPS yet, but I had one of the guys from my league, Ice Smitty, the greatest.
Right.
He is a beast with Earth. I'd put him right up there with you.
The DPS I'm most impressed with.
He was burning things down so fast in that alert.
Yeah.
I was just like, wow. He was like testing out. I think he was testing out a crush loadout for that. Yeah. And he was just annihilating things.
Like, I was like, before I was collecting my tank gear because the DPSing wasn't enjoyable to play, you know, it wasn't really flows or all that kind of stuff. But now you go in, like, I'm still vestments gear and keeping up with full tier 6 players, and It's so fun. So,
all the DPSing?
Yeah, the DPSing.
Yeah.
So I cannot wait to get full tier 6, like level 6 expert mods will probably be out then. I don't know when by the time I've done that. And to be seeing the damage that's coming out. Because I'm hitting like 15Ks. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. So it's really, really fun.
Yeah, I mean, you're using hand blasters, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hand blasters is beast, especially that change they made to explosive shot with the bow combo.
Yeah.
When you go into explosive shot, because now it hits multiple targets. And I'm doing the same thing too, man. I'm hitting for like 15K. As I think I crit one for like 18 one time. I was like, oh my god.
with that weapon mastery, though, if you imagine, like, when you know, let's say, I don't know, this time next year, we've got all those more skill points. We've got like 220 skill points. We spec'd into all of that all the weapon masteries. We're going to have like tier 7. We're going to be hitting like 30Ks off.
I know. I know.
It's going to be one shot in, you know, gonna be Ursa and stuff. In
you know, one rage DPS is going to walk into like the subconstruct raid and just like slowly walk through it and like dreadful blast. Dreadful blast.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what they're going to do, but it's just going to be ridiculous. Weapon mastery is OP.
Yeah, it's definitely hitting hard. There's a lot of people complaining about it for PvP, which I can see where they're coming from, because it is kind of like one of those, so it's like, this, you know, whoever gets their weapon mastery combo off first and best, you know, is going to end up winning.
For dueling, I definitely see that. Like, it only takes one block break into a weapon mastery combo, and then there's no coming back.
Especially
yeah, dude,
if you're prec modded.
Yeah. Yeah, if you're precision modded and everything, yeah, you're going to be hitting them hard. I got actually got accused of berserking in a duel last night because I hit an earth tank for 8K. Nice. But he was debuffed at the time, and he did not realize that. Because, yes, I do use debuffs against tanks because I only fight in DPS stance. You're going to crutch me, I'm going to kick your crutch out from underneath you. but yeah, weapon mastery is hitting so freaking hard. I was dueling some people and all that. I've like the shields big scoop combo. I hit a buddy of mine in my league. I hit him for 15K with it. Just the weapon mastery part, not even the power part. And it was like more health than he actually had. So I don't know if they're going to be toning that down or anything. I do know that in update 38, they are toning down the precision buffs.
Yeah.
Yeah, the nature carnage and the other stuff as well. I saw the nature carnage, although I don't think that needed nerve.
So maybe that will help a bit with how, you know, big the bursts are.
Well, reinforce was giving me more precision than my trinket was.
Yeah, yeah, but like, can you imagine
precision?
Yeah, but imagine the guys that are, you know, stacking the trinket with the reinforce.
Yeah, exactly.
All that, you know, it's like, you know, I've gotten my precision up to almost like 5,000.
Yeah,
and that's.
I'm trying to see where that says that with the powers. Is it all precision buffs?
It's all precision buffs. Yeah, yes,
bloodlust. Carnage, reinforce. I'm just trying to think. It's down. It's on the patch notes.
Carnage as well. Yeah, it's basically every position buff. I'm guessing then. All right.
I'm scrolling down the test notes right now here. Well, so like I guess they added a new build. One of the big things about that survival mastery thing that everybody was talking about, you know, and that group of P players from Community Council that made it to round 7 was there was like no breaks, so they kind of figured out a way of how to like keep an ad busy so they could take breaks and all that, because like they were in there for like hours, you know, doing stuff. You know, when you're playing something like that for like hours on end, and all that, you know, you need to take breaks. People need to stop and use the bathroom. People need to, you know, just like get up and like stretch their fingers out. stuff like that. Some people got kids they got to deal with and everything. So I guess they are adding breaks now, a 10-minute break every three rounds to the survival mode. So they can use the terminal again to start the next round.
Meps, I think, said on FNL that they were going to work out a way to allow people to start at a particular round.
No, I don't think so. I think once you if you get to round seven, all that, and then you completely wipe out of there and all, you got to start over from the beginning.
Yeah, that's now, but I think in the future they might be looking to otherwise, you know, if when we've got tier 10 and we're coming back to this this event to do that, we're going to need to do 1 to 7, which will be easier then. So I think he's...
So they're going to give us, like, checkpoints to start
yeah,
up
back over. Yeah, I think, like, a checkpoint.
I guess that'd be kind of cool, yeah.
Because otherwise, you know what I mean? Like, when, you know, a year down the line, we've got full tier 8. And we go back, and this one comes back out. We've got to do, like, the 7... We've already got all those styles, and we've got to go through all the way around.
Well, from my understanding, these are always supposed to be attuned to whatever the end game content is. So next year, when we got like, you know, next year or two, if we got tier 8, you know, when we go in there to start this and all that, it's going to start off at like a tier 8 difficulty. That's at least the way I understood it. Could be wrong about that.
Okay.
Orbit, someone just asked, when are you doing some more PvP floatouts? And I'm sure you uploaded a 1v1 PvP, didn't you?
Yeah, I uploaded one literally about an hour ago. I don't use many PvP loadouts. I'm still working on a scrimmage one. I haven't found... I'm using one at the moment, but I want to do more testing on that. I don't tank in PvP. Only, like, as a fake tank. But if you're looking for a proper tank... for PvP, just use a normal tank and loadout, but without the pulls. That's what I'd do. Just slap in some else instead of those slots.
Everybody DPSs and tank stuns, though.
No, you'll be surprised.
Really?
Arenas? Yeah, you'd be surprised how many, I call them no tanks, are out there.
No, I'm not talking about no tanks. I'm talking about 5v5. All the tanks that I've ever knew, they always had the whole DPS spec and DPS loadout.
Yeah. Oh, I understand what you're saying. Yeah.
Except without like, the debuff
if
removal.
If you look at the whole community, though, only like a small portion of people do fives and fours scrimmages.
Yeah, I know.
And there's a lot of annoying fuckers at Q1B1 with full tank gear.
Yeah, and I don't get that. I mean, I understand maybe an arena. All right, an arena's like pretty much anything goes, I guess. You know, because, you know, you're in there to, you know, win marks and all that stuff. And all that. But the ones that I don't understand are the ones who do it in duels. I really don't get it. You know, the people, you know, who, you know, go in there in their support role, you know, taking advantage of, you know, whatever stat buffs they get, and then, you know, the thing that cracks me up about it is they do that, and then they complain about it if you debuff them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm like, like I said, if you're going to use a crutch, I'm going to kick it out from underneath you. I mean, that's just, you're going to come into a fight with a crutch, I'm going to kick it out from underneath you. That's just the way it is. I mean, the only way to do, like, legit 1v1s, seriously, the only way to do legit 1v1s to figure out who's actually better than the other, right, is DPS stance with no pets and no supercharges. Bottom line.
Or consumables.
consumables make a right. big difference
and,
now.
Yeah, no supercharges, consumables, pets.
Orbit, the chat is froze in the video, but don't know if you saw that.
I don't think it's froze.
It's froze on mine.
Try refreshing it. I don't think it's froze. It hasn't froze.
Oh, okay. Brittany's here.
Brittany's here.
Brittany. why is Brittany so evil?
good question. I think she enjoys it, to be honest with you.
She's a villain by heart.
But yeah, so, you know, that's the thing that cracks me up. People, you know, come up to me, they want to fight me in like tank stance and everything, and then I beat them, and then they cry I cheated because I used a debuff move on them. And I'm like,
well, I just put my jewel when I just before I did my PvP loadout, I was testing it out a little bit. I put my dueling invites on. And obviously when I've got my dual invite, I just get swarmed by the whole fucking watchtower. They don't give you enough time to get power or anything.
Oh, I know. I know.
It's just spamming out. And so half the time I'm fighting with no jewels, and you come up against full-on tanks using consumables, pets, just every fucking thing. I don't say anything, but it's just amusing the people that will do what they will go through to get a win.
Yeah. Oh, and Viper in the chat. Okay, Viper, I completely agree with you like that. All right, if it's like open world, all right, and you know you're going up against somebody from the opposite faction and all that, by all means, unload on them. I don't care if you're a hero or a villain, unload on them.
Hmm.
You know,
use everything you got. Everything.
You know, but I mean, you know, when I'm talking about like you know when you know somebody comes up there, to duel you and all that, they challenge you to a duel, I mean, you should expect a fair fight in that. I mean, go in there and all that, and, you know, next thing you know, he's using a supply drop. Oh, here comes his sidekick. Oh, now the backup's out. Oh, gosh, I'm getting orbital struck. You know, I mean, I'm like, come on.
I think if a tank wants to go in tank stance and test himself, he needs to fight another tank. And they're actually good fights.
Like, yeah. Yeah. I mean, roll versus roll fights are awesome. Roll versus roll fights. I've sat there and watched healers duel for like half an hour.
Oh, the.
And I've just sat there and been like. Ugh. I've just been like, come on. You know, it's like, you know, I've been like. I've actually tried to get people from the other faction to come in and gank them, just so the fight would be over.
I remember a friend of mine, he wasn't even in full Android gear, and he would used to fight someone from Orbit's League. He's in his league as well, and he wasn't in full gear, and they were both healers, nature healers, and they were fighting for like an hour and 20 minutes or something like that. And that only because the other healer kept on popping sodas and all sorts of stuff. It was so funny. And it was Yonsei, I think, Orbit. He was fighting for him for like 1.5 hours nearly. It just didn't end until one of them DC'd. I don't know who, though. It's mad.
I tell you what, though, those kind of long fights that you have, they get you better at reading block breaks and countering and everything. I used to do tank with tank, and that's helped me with PvP in a lot. Just
definitely,
because you've got so much time of just pure PvP of just working down and constantly grinding it out. Zed Shadow used to call me out every day. Orbit, get to Star Labs now.
Bring your tank gear. He used to have really good block breaks, so he always used to catch me. It was unbelievable, and he had he used to mod his gear with like full resto prec.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure.
He
was very good duelist.
Yeah, he was a good jeweler. He was like a tank. He was a tank jeweler. He loved to duel tanks. And
yeah.
But the thing is, I was always a DPS. So whenever I challenged, well, he challenged me. I would just get my dusty tank gear out of the bank. And like, I only ever like dueled him really. And so yeah, he beat me like more times than I beat him. He was really good.
He still plays. He just doesn't duel anymore. He only does 5v5.
Goiku Star asked me a question, but I'm gonna put it to you two. I'll answer, but I'm gonna put it to you two. Orbit. All right. Now, without you know, dissing on our boy too much and all that, what do you have to say about Nimbus's fighting style?
Oh, I. If I was a person, but I guess that's just like Nimbus nature without making him sound bad. If he was fighting me and he would be flying, I would rage. I would rage so much because I have seen so many videos where he's doing his block breaks, doing his combos, and he only gets knocked down like once every half an hour. And if he would do that to me in a duel, I would flip.
Okay, let me ask you a question about that. Because everybody brings up the fact that he goes up in the air.
Yeah.
Everybody always brings it up. How is him going up in the air any different than people using the acro tumbling mod?
Well, we don't really have that in the EU server. The most people on the EU
It's in the game, so everybody has it. Everybody has it available.
Yeah, but they're hardly used. That's the thing. I already asked this Nimbus today. I was like, "Why? What is it with you guys and flight mode? Isn't super speed just better for PvP, for kiting, and all that kind of stuff? Because you can't really kite with flight. All you can do is just roll away, like, really slowly. And the acrobat, we hardly have any acrobats apart from Balkan.
Apart from Balkan,
I don't know any acrobat players apart from Balkan. And of one of my alts, which I made when I started the game, is acrobat. But super speed is just that what EU players use. We don't have that problem with people flying about apart from Effany. She's flight, but I know she would be a sneaky one once in a while and would fly and kill people. But in a duel, if somebody flies around, we normally call that noob. So
I personally don't have a problem with people flying in duels. I actually think it gives them a disadvantage, to be honest.
Yeah,
in some ways it does. In some ways it does. Yeah.
Yeah. I think. I think it's a lot easier to see when they block and that. For some reason, they're slower, but they can be cheeky at times. And sometimes when they are, like, really high and the arena is just over your head, then you can't really see what they're doing when they're up high. It's annoying sometimes, but...
It is a little bit annoying, but...
I wouldn't duel Nimbus. Nimbus does
fight a good case and say that, you know, the heroes... You know, superheroes fly, and they use their powers to whatever he says about it.
Superheroes don't fly.
How can you say heroes don't fly?
Do you not know who Superman is? You not know who's Superman, Power Girl, Wonder Woman, Super, you know, come on.
Name a superhero.
Lex Luthor flies.
Name a superhero who doesn't fly.
Lex Luthor flies. Lex Luthor flies.
Flash Cersei doesn't flies. Fly.
Okay, yeah, there's obviously
nobody
one.
Nobody cares about Flash.
There's a lot of players that fight. Was your question his fighting style or his trolling style?
Well, see, that's something I was going to get into. All right, because I was going to mention about it. Nimbus. His fighting style, it's unique. It's definitely his own. He's worked out, you know, things on his own that he does. It may not be the best and the smartest and all that. It may not be what everybody else does. But, I mean, he's made it work for him against, you know, people before in the past. He's got a lot of rust he's got to knock off. Don't get me wrong. I mean, dude's been away for a while and all that. And hasn't really, you know, gotten back out there. And we actually talked about this the other day, me and him. He knows he needs to, get the kinks out, oil it up and all everything like that. He needs to, you know, make his return like Ali did when he got out of prison, you know. So he knows all that. Now, as far as the way he mentally combats somebody, oh dude, it's a lost cause. I mean, people get mad at him so easily. It's just hilarious.
The thing is, Nimbus also has like his own trolling style when it comes to fights. He will, if it's true or not, he will just talk so much and it would override that person into thinking, okay, you know what, can't be asked to fucking think of what he just said. Fuck it, I'm done. I can imagine, like, the only way to fight against Nimbus is to actually do a fight, like, on YouTube, like American Hero and Nimbus did, I can imagine American Hero writing everything down, what Nimbus just said, because it's just so much input, and then be like, okay, check, point two, point three. just taking hours on making a video against Nimbus. He talks so much, and his brain works so fast that it blows my mind.
Yeah,
I couldn't fight
toes,
against him.
He's quick on his toes.
Yeah. He's exhausting.
Nimbus likes to do something that I refer to as full-lifing people with words.
Oh, yes.
Ugh. That's what Nimbus does. You know, I mean, honest to God, you know, I'm gonna be honest with everybody out there right now. Right now, does Nimbus, you know, take his persona seriously? Absolutely, he does. Yes, but you know what? I sat in the game with him last night for probably a good 3 hours, just watching him and myself, and you know, taking part in, you know, firing back at some of these haters we've got in this game, and we were both just sitting in League chat laughing the whole time. Whole time laughing at these guys, you know, trying to say, oh, I'm not mad, you're mad, okay. I was like yeah, I mean, he posted up a video. I was, you know, Nimbus has got this, you know, he's got this they know that, you know, you gotta pay him to duel him, right? If you're coming at him out of anger, you gotta pay him to duel him. You know, if he doesn't know you gotta pay him to duel him, and he's charging $500 million. So he's charging $500 million for it, and you know, and honestly, God, I swear to God, you know, people are saying, "Oh, he'll just take the money and log off." No, he will duel you if you pay him $500 million, and he doesn't care if he wins or loses. He's still got $500 million.
Yeah. But he's always a winner if he's getting $500 million.
Exactly. But so, like, you know, it's like he posts up a video of him going down and dealing with one of these shark guys. Sent him a duel, all right, and just as the counter was about ready to, you know, start the duel, he flew out before the duel could start, and he said, "Ha ha, psych, 500 mil."
Yeah, I watched that video today.
Like Halan just said, he may not be a good PvPer, but he can show verbal PvP. He's probably the best verbal PvPer out there. No one can keep up with that guy.
Yeah.
He knows how to make someone rage or someone to quit.
He's an entertainer, like he says.
Yeah.
And just a little message out there to all you guys out there hating on me and Nimbus. Hating Nimbus because, you know, you don't talk, you know, because you guys don't, you know, get where he's what he's doing. You know, I mean, he's doing it just to piss you off, and it's working.
Mm-hmm.
And for all you guys out there, you know, hating and bagging on me, talking, you know, for, you know, Not you know, doing or saying anything against him for what he does or says. I mean, now don't get me wrong. There are times where I don't agree with him with some of the things that he says and some of his tactics, you know, that, and we talk about that. But it's between me and him. It's not up to y'all. Y'all don't need to be involved in that. Yeah. Me and Nimbus are friends and all that. It's between us. So, you know, just to put this all to bed here, all right. I kind of lost track of what I was saying.
It to bed.
I mean, as you know, I mean, so you know, me and Nimbus, all right, and so I told these guys this was last night in the game. Me and Nimbus have been doing this for 3.5 years, not just playing the game, but dealing with people just hating on us because they don't try to understand us. They don't even try and get to know us and all that, or they just, you know, flat out, somebody told them to, basically, which is mostly the case with a lot of people. Somebody told you to hate us. Hate on us, so like little blind sheep, you're following along with whatever, you know, clique that you're trying to fit into. Like I said, we've been doing this for 3.5 years. We've dealt with this level of hate at directed at us before, right? In those past 3.5 years, we will over the next 3.5 years. The thing is, though, the people that were hating on us in year one, don't bother with it anymore. The people that hated us in year two, don't bother with it anymore. Some of them I actually, you know, hang out with and talk to and I'm cool with. Now, the people who are hating on us now, right now, all right, you're either going to fade away or you're just going to get over it. But either way, you're not getting rid of us. That's all I got to say about that. Anyways,
there we go.
What's next?
I think Aphrodite should change her profile picture on Skype.
Why?
Why?
She's got those come to bed eyes.
Wow.
My what?
I've got the Twitch thing on, and I've got your face like next to it, and it's just distracting me.
Okay, fine.
Arbitrary Falser, I'm not sure who you are in game.
Thanks for the compliment.
Most likely Arbitrary. All right, if I said anything or talked smack about killing you in a game, it's because you said something first. I normally, for the very most part, do not initiate any trash talking in this game, unless it's somebody that I feel needs to be trash talked. I don't normally set out to start any trash talking in the game, though.
Hate the trash talk in this game sometimes. I love banter. I have banter all the time, right? Mm-hmm. But trash talk is just a whole different level. It just makes the game a bit more serious, and the game shouldn't be serious at all. This game, I know now why most MMOs don't have... chats for people to talk in, like Final Fantasy or EVE Online and World of Warcraft. Do they? They don't have the one, do they?
That's the thing. Somebody said
they don't have about, one because yeah. there's too much hassle on it. And I am so glad that DC has one. Otherwise, I probably wouldn't play it. I love the social side of DC. It makes it so much more fun and enjoyable, even though the game might be, you know, even though it's like grinding the same stuff over and over again. But people do ruin it at times, and they overdo it. And I don't...
Somebody left a comment on one of my videos mentioning that. It's like, man, I'm going back to Final Fantasy. Final Fantasy doesn't have near as much drama as DC does. Yeah. I was like, because Final Fantasy doesn't have a voice chat system in it. End of the day, bottom line, that's it.
See, I like DC, but recently I haven't been on DC much, and that's just simply because of some people with... It put everybody on ignore, and it just brings you down when you see people in PP chat cussing each other off, especially people that you like, and you think, oh, I might want to get involved just to help them out, but then at the end of the day, you get stuck in the middle of it, so you keep out of it. It's a bit... They should be able to report people which actually speak as well. So,
That's an issue and all that. That's I wish, you know, at times myself.
You can't prove it's their voice or some shit.
Well,
yeah.
If they do say, you can. I think they should. Don't they do the same with text chat that they keep book of it?
No.
Type in what? No.
No. They, oh, okay. No. The type.
They
the
do
typing,
that on other
yes.
games.
The typing, yes. The text chat, yes.
Okay.
But the voice channels, you know, what goes on actually in the voice over microphones and all that, they don't record at all.
Oh, that's too bad. Well, never mind. I still like the game. I'm not going to leave the game over some, you know, assholes.
Nice descriptive word there.
I was going to say something more detailed, but let's just not go there.
How's the cookies?
I haven't eaten yet. I've got them open, but I'm doing some. I'm drinking now. I'm an alcoholic.
Jesus.
Confessions. DCO Confessions podcast.
Hey, so something else with the updates on the test server right now. Did you guys see this about the teleporters?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
So these teleporters, I didn't get what kind of teleporters these are. Are these just for the Hall of Doom or what you want to pick or?
You need to slow down on that alcohol, Aphrodite, you're slowing your legs.
You're lush. Well, basically, I guess some of the basic mods on, they're going to take you to certain locations. Like, you know, one will take you to like the Superman statue and everything like that. And you can equip these into your generator. But then they're going to come out with other mods and everything that may take you to, like, very exclusive spots. You know, like, maybe we'll get one that will teleport us directly into Gotham Under Siege instead of having to go from Metro to PD to the Watchtower to the Themyscira base to Under Siege.
Basically, it's like the teleporters you now get in the, what's his name? I'm one of the police stations, and they either go to the watchtower or the other ones.
Right, but these you're going to be able to have in your lair, from what I understand.
Yeah.
Ah, that's good.
So, I mean, if you're working on, like I was, on the Central City Bounty Feat, for example, you could set it up for Central City, and that's what I would do. Like, for whatever feat I was doing, I'd make sure I've got teleported, just for throwing me straight over that way.
That would be a bit unfair for the other people which want to actually catch up with you.
Well, I've already done it, so there we go. And you need to get off your ass and stop drinking alcohol, and you might be able to catch me up. But yeah, it's only available in the market. It's only available in the marketplace.
I'll catch you up soon, one day. When I've done 500 bounties, never going to happen.
I'm actually getting close, man. I'm getting close. I'm under 100 to go.
I'm on 60, I think. 60, 100. I haven't done it that often.
Wow.
The first time I did the bounties is when I joined Orbitz League. And sad fact, my ult, which is basically my main now, has more skill points than my main, I think. Yes.
Is that really a sad fact?
Yeah, it is sad. Because I had my main for like over a year, so.
Yeah, well, we do. Your alt is now your main.
Yeah, but yeah, I had my main a lot longer, and I was really lazy with that.
What we do in my league is we have a bounty night. We have a bounty night, and I was not like, you know, we all, you know, we need to get like 3 raid groups to go after all these bounties or anything like that, but it's just something for us to do as a league and all that, and we hang out through with each other, joke around and everything like that, and we just go around, we do all the CC bounties, plus we do the M-Bot and the O-Bot bounties.
Fuck signing in on bounty night.
I think you should do those bounty nights, Orbitz.
I've got to go cinema on bounty night.
But it's just a fun thing we do. We do it like once a week and all that. And if guys want to go out and do the bounties and everything, they're all fine with that. But there was another guy in my league. It's kind of like you asked. he's like, 4 more of these CC bounties and I hit 50. I'm like, well, I know who's taking over this when I'm done. And he's like, no. But we just have fun with that and everything. It's like one time a week, I think.
So going back to the teleporters, it's obviously only available on the marketplace, so we can only buy it.
The teleporters themselves are marketplace items, yes, but everything that, as far as like the higher end like locations that you can use to teleport to areas, those are going to be dropping off of, from what I understand, those are going to be dropping off of bosses and instances. And some of the lower tiered ones, like the more common locations, are going to be dropping off of ads and stuff.
That's for the generator, though, isn't it?
Right.
Yeah, for the generator. But so, do you know how the stats are going to work? Because apparently you can mod the generator to increase your stats.
Yes. Yeah, they are introduced the stat mod benefits for the generators and all that. I mean, they're not huge from what I saw, because Trex was showing me on the test server Friday night when we were doing a source cast, and they're not huge stat boosts by any means, but they are, you know, stat boosts and all that, and can definitely be an advantage. And that stat boost isn't just if you're in your lair and all that. That's where, if you go anywhere.
Yeah, that's nice.
So you permanently have those stat boosts on. That looks really cool.
What kind of stats are they? Are they like precision buffs or
crit? You can put, well, there's different types you could put in. There's like support, you know, damage and stuff like that. I'd have to look at that screen again.
Yeah, I haven't had a closer look at that. I need to do that as well. More ways to get powerful. I just think after all these DLCs and everything, we're just going to be overpowered eventually. You know what I mean?
I like how changed your picture. All right,
I have pictures on Skype. Give me a break. I've got rid of my dreamy eyes.
Change your picture from the bedroom eyes, quote unquote, as Orbitz put it. To the Grand Canyon cleavage pic.
Oh, that That sounds like I've got that's not very nice.
Balkan would definitely be in the fap cave right now if he was here.
I love that expression. Oh, that's like the best thing ever. Now off to the fap cave.
Yes, Brittany, we know you finished your feats a while ago. Brittany has completed every single feat in the game, everybody. For all of you. How many skill points are you up to now, Brittany, with everything that they added? Is it 189 now? Is that the max? Did you know there's a difference between how many feat points you can earn between the villains and the hero side?
No, didn't
I? Yeah. The villains can get more feat points than the heroes can right now.
Why?
I mean, it's not significant. I think it's maybe 25 more feat points. I don't know. There's a differing in some of the feats somewhere.
Oh. Hmm.
She is at 189.9 is the max on the villain.
What's the max on the hero?
189.85. So there's a 15 feat point difference between heroes and villains.
5 feet point.
How many skill points you want, Brittany?
She's got 189.9.
No, she said max on villain. That's not how much she has.
No, she's
yeah, it is. She's maxed on villain and hero.
Yeah.
Wow. She's been doing all kinds of glitches. Trust me. Oh man.
I don't know if you're ignoring your Skype or anything, but I've asked if you wanted to join the show or not, and oops, you're ignoring me on Skype. Anyways.
You can't get her back on again. She'll just, hail me some more.
You can't handle that, can you?
I'm actually pretty used to it now. Please.
Orbit is jelly.
Jelly.
But yeah, the stat boosts are coming for the generators and all that. Obviously, we got teleporters coming too, and of course, the survival mode. All on the test server right now with update 38. What I want to talk about, though, is in the last few minutes here we got is Lee Calls, update 39.
We talked about that last week.
No, I want to talk about it more. I really want to talk. I'm really excited for League Halls. I'm really excited for League Halls, damn it.
Okay, well, you can fire us off with what it is that you want to talk about League Halls.
Well, I mean, it's like, you know, I came up with some other ideas and all that for, like, things that League Halls could do for the league. You know, because, you know, not just, you know, place for everybody to hang out and everything like that. But I'm talking about, like, you know, give us, like, a shared R&D. If you're in the league, all right. If you know somebody in the league has a plan, like right now, like my league's, you know, having issues with getting the line plan, right? Because it's not that we don't have it; it's just the majority of the people who do have it are premium, so they can't even make the damn sodas, right? You know, a shared R&D, you know, so that way you don't have to wait, Orbit, if you need, you know, a dominance and precision mod for, you know, tanking, say somebody in your league got the dominant precision 6 expert mod when the next DLC comes out, right? They got it. You need it to mod your gear, but they're not online, right? But you need it right now, or you want it right now. You'd be able to go into your league call, go up to your R&D station, see that, you know, somebody in the league has that plan, and you'd be able to make that mod.
I think, yeah, that's a good idea. I think maybe instead of having that, instead of equipping, you can either have two options. Either equip it or put it into a league R&D, if that makes sense.
Right. Yeah.
The only reason why I say that is because I don't think they would ever allow you to... I don't think that would ever happen the way you were saying.
What?
That just if you had it equipped, anyone in the league would be able to use that. I think you'd need to have a duplicate and put it in to a, like equip it to a separate thing for the league to be able to use it.
Apparently, you're still quiet, Orbit.
Yeah, quiet again.
No, I've just kind of, you know, blocked Brittany so she can't hear me.
Yeah, I'm getting told that somebody can't hear you at all now.
That noise just came back. You probably can hear me now. Yeah, that sound came back. I don't know what the hell that is, guys. Don't know what that is.
Not me.
Pretty sure it's Super Patriot, but he doesn't want to confess to that.
It is not me with that noise.
What noise is it?
See?
It's not me with that
sound
noise.
Sounds like it's by the sea.
Everybody's
like, the I'm sea. On the beach. I'm on the beach, guys.
Under the sea.
Just chilling on the beach.
Something else,
in the ocean. No, carry on.
Please, let me ask you a question. All right, if they do the shared bank, league bank, how worried are you about somebody just, like, you know, pilfering it?
I think they shouldn't do that because
they're going to do it because everybody, because a lot of people want it, and you know, and it would be beneficial to have.
Yeah, they'll do the league banks, but they'll have ranks. Different ranks have different availabilities to the league rank.
I guess I'll go then.
Because what we said last week, Super, is if someone, you know, you've just invited some random guy to
the league,
and then they just wipe the league bank and leave. Fuck off.
Yeah,
that's what I was just about to say as well. I can imagine that happening.
Set restrictions on how much they can pull out and everything like that. Yeah, I definitely agree with that.
The bottom rank wouldn't be able to pull anything out of the bag. No way.
Yeah.
In my
opinion. One thing I really want, I'd really like to see is some league feats associated, right?
Yes.
Like, you know, as a league, you know, you beat, you know, all the tier 2 raids.
Yeah, that would be cool.
And also have like a trophy room for, like, you know, you get, you know, a trophy, you know, you beat a raid with your league. You get a trophy and all that, and you get to hang up another trophy. So, like, you know, you'd have, like, you know, like a broken off piece from the Avatar attack from Subconstruct. You could put up in the trophy room, or like Ra's al Ghul's sword. You can, you know, hang it up there and everything, saying, you know, you beat the League of Assassins alert and stuff like that. That would be really cool.
Yeah, league feats does sound good. Good idea. That fucking noise has come back. The tides just come in again, guys. Don't know what that is.
But it has to be something that you had to earn it with the league at the time. So, like, and, you know, you'd have to actually do that run, and if you joined the league, you didn't automatically get the feed. That would keep people from, like, league hopping.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At least too much.
Problem with that, though, if you've got smaller leagues, like with only 4 or 5 guys in.
Yeah. See, I mean, I know for feats like that, though, you know, like all the tier 2 raids, beat all the tier 3 raids, stuff like that. I know that's not something that's, like, huge for, like, established leagues, you know, leagues that are doing tier 6 stuff and all that. It's not, like, a huge accomplishment for them. My thing is, look at it from, like, a newer player who just started off, you know, found friends onto the game, and they all start a league together, and then going through and accomplishing all that stuff as they, you know, are progressing up in their tiers and everything. That would be, like, one of those things. Hey, guys, let's go after that freaking, let's go get that contact speed feat.
Yeah. maybe have a separate rank, like a dedication rank or something. You know, every time you complete a league feat, you build up a separate rank or something. Would be quite cool.
Well, you know, they did talk also about having, like, the statuary in the game, which would be, you know, basically kind of like your league leaderboards, too, where you could set up, you know, it's like, you know, who had, you know, the highest damage, I guess you could say, who had the most deaths. So we were joking.
Yeah,
I'm
looking forward to seeing the what different options you can have to set. With the league, leaderboards. Hey,
Carolyn Carnage from the DCUO Social Club is in the chat. Hello, Carolyn. Carolyn's a longtime DCUO player. She's been around. I've had many of fights with her in Open World since launch. She's saying league feeds to get different perks, like more room in your league bank or different amenities. That would be kind of cool. I'm actually kind of curious about how we're going to be able to decorate these things. Like, can anybody, if they have permission to go in and set down items, layer items that they've gotten from Open World or from that they have in their own inventory?
Problem is, you're going to have like different personalities, different. People wanting to. Thing is, everyone's going to want to edit everyone else, and they're going to feel offended if they haven't got the option to do that.
Yeah,
that's always the problem with leagues. You can't please everybody.
Yeah.
What's that? I keep saying. You can please some of the people some of the time. You can please all of the people some of the time. No, all the people never. I don't know. Something like that.
Okay.
You can please some of the people all of the time. All of the people.
Some of the time, but not all the people all the time.
There you go. That's the one I'm thinking of. Fucking hell.
You've done all of it.
Still got the distracting image in front of me, Aphrodite.
I'm not. I might as well put one in for my dog in a minute.
I just want to stand back and go, hello. One thing I would like us to be able to finally do with the game is a league emblem.
Yes. Yeah.
Some way to design our own league emblem or design one off game and somehow get it onto the game. Submit it for, because I'm sure that they're going to want to be able to approve any kind of league emblems we put in there, because if not, people will be having because apparently people will be having all sorts of like dick pics and stuff for their league emblems, and I see it.
Is that better for you?
something like that.
When did you take that one of yourself?
The other day.
Yeah, sorry, Carrie, say, but carry on, say,
but I mean, I'm sure that they're gonna, the only issue I see with us being able to make our own league emblems or even our own personal emblems is, the TOS for the game and the ESRB rating for the game, because I'm sure there's gonna be a lot of people out there with like people make emblems with like dildos and stuff on them and.
Thing is, Call of Duty have got that though.
Other
games do.
And they ban people from the game doing that on Call of Duty. My thing is though, the presence isn't there on DCUO to handle that kind of stuff.
They I'm not sure if you played. That's flipping waves are coming back again. Jesus, can you guys hear that?
No.
Absolute tidal waves coming in. But
Could you stop taking a bath while we're
a bath.
If we could design our own emblem, right, and then submit it to them for approval that this emblem's not offensive in any way and all that, and then we could add it into our league. That would be something really cool. Cuz those wall banners and all that you can actually put the emblems on.
I still yet to see one, but yeah, I know what you're talking about.
I've got like a couple in my lairs. Being able to see, walk into the league hall and then see, the banners hanging down with the league emblem on, that would be really epic.
I'm pretty sure with league halls, they've got to have like league colors, a league theme. They've got to have that. The emblem, would be cool.
Yeah, I agree, Neo. That would take a while for dev approval of or QA approval of a league emblem. But I mean, it'd be really cool if we had that option. I'd be willing to wait for it. I know you would too, Neo. Neo Synapse is in my league in the chat there.
Have you Did you play Grand Theft Auto 5?
Yes, I have.
Yeah, they had...
I'm playing it right now. What a coincidence.
That's a coincidence. They had... You know, you could make your gang, or what do they call that?
The gang gang members. You can make it.
You could do that, and you could, and offline they had like a separate little program or website, whatever, where you could
social rockstar.
Yeah, that's it. And you could design your emblem, and it's got all of your league, all of your gang in there, and it shows all the stats and everything. That would be quite cool to have on DC. Yeah. Imagine if you could log on DC Universe Online and see your whole league, see their skill points, see their, you know, their loadouts, or I don't know, just see everything. See how long they've been playing. I'd love that.
Cliff412 says they need new powers for free players. Why? First of all, any new power they introduce in the game is going to be in a DLC, which the free players are going to have to pay for.
Yeah, there's right. never going to be a free. There's no. They've got plenty.
There's never going to be another free power. Second of all, though, I mean, we've got a lot of powers to choose from right now as it is. I mean, we've got a lot. I mean, we've got, what, 4 tanks?
We need water powers, just saying.
Water powers. Everybody's went into water powers.
I was the first to say that.
I actually heard something from, speaking of power, new powers, I actually heard something from someone in-game. No idea if this is true. No idea. He said he's been hearing from a few people that the next power set is not going to have a DPS role, and it's just going to be healer and troll role.
Who said that?
But that would be absolutely
shit. It would be cool. I think it'd be cool, personally.
No, it wouldn't. As much of a role as DPS actually is, all right, damage role is, it's still really only classified as a stance, not a role in itself. Don't get upset with me, you DPS only guys out there. All right, I'm not saying that to put you all down. All right, but that's just the basic way it is. Brittany, I cannot remember the last time you beat me at anything. All right.
She beat you to 189.85.
She's got me beating skill points. That's about it. Wait, what are they talking about? I've got what power?
You have that power.
I have what? The water power? No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I've got a fan. I've got a fan in the chat. Super Patriot is
mental.
I've got a fan in the chat. DCO is dead thanks to Super Patriot banning people for being him in PvP. I don't have the power to ban people in this game. But everybody's talking about, you know, because, you know, I report glitches and I report people for racism. They call me a snitch and a wannabe GM. First off, yeah, if you're upset with me for, you know, reporting people for hate speech and being racist and belittling other people of either ethnic or sexual choices or backgrounds, then you're a bigot yourself. All right. Secondly, there is no way I am trying to become a GM in this game, because I know for a fact I cannot be partial enough to be one. So there you go.
Heard it here first.
I did look into it, though. I did look into it a while back when I did have some interest in being a GM, and I didn't want to move to San Diego. I've been to San Diego. I don't like San Diego.
Sweet. Well, should we wrap it up?
Yeah, I think Brittany hits the point on nail on the head right there and all that. Stop being racist or doing things that will get you suspended, and you don't have to worry about getting suspended or banned.
Exactly.
In the words of Jim Carrey from the movie Liar Liar, stop breaking the law, asshole.
Per se.
Hersey. Speaking of which, Nimbus will be back with us next week. Vulcan is taking a short break from the show for right now. We hope he comes back because I know everybody out there listening to the show loves Vulcan being on the show. We love having Vulcan on the show because he is our little buddy and he's funny. He's funny. But hopefully we'll see what we can do about getting Vulcan back on here when he's able to and all that. He's just taking a break for personal reasons. And all that has nothing really to do with whatever people may want to say it does. All right. His reasons are his own, and he's asked me, at least, I don't know if he talked to Orbit or not, to keep those reasons private because they are part of his private life. So we'll leave it at that. But anyways, Nimbus should be back with us next week. Maybe we'll have a special guest. We shall see. I don't know.
We'll try to get one for next week.
Yeah, I tried to get Brittany to come back on, you know, and she didn't want to. Apparently, she's ignoring us.
Look, I'm gonna kick her ass this week.
Stop being so mean to Brittany.
That'll give us something to talk about for next week.
But you guys got anything final you want to say?
No. What the fuck was that?
I was a bit lost then.
Who was that?
What?
I heard something in the background.
That was me.
Wasn't
oh,
me.
Oh, that might have been my game, GTA, sorry.
Oh, right, yeah. Someone's screaming in the background. Like, who the fuck is that?
Yeah, that's Trevor. He's screaming.
Oh, okay. Well, no, I don't have anything else to say. Thanks for tuning in. Are we going to make this... We need to set a day and a time regular because we don't need to.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah,
I know.
So Tuesday 8 p.m. every week?
Yeah, Tuesday 8 p.m. UK time. There will be 3 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time here in the U.S.
Every Tuesday, guys. So catch us next week. Make sure you keep tuning in. We're going to try and make it as a regular timing because we've been sporadic the last few weeks.
Af, you got anything to say?
Yeah. Thanks for tuning in and listening to us.
Check the love I'm getting in the chat. Super. I love Orbit. No homo. I love Orbit. He's hot. I broke up with my girlfriend for him. So I've got a lot of male attention in the chat right now.
So are you going to meet up with this Stop SP? Oh wow! Now I know what that name means.
Yeah. Just put that together.
Oh, I was a bit slow on that, sorry. Wow. Someone took a lot of time to themselves.
Yeah. Yeah. I've got very dedicated fans out there. anyways, you guys heard them both and all that. On behalf of myself, and Orbit and Af, who already set themselves. I want to thank you guys all for stopping by and listening in to the People's Podcast. If you didn't catch the live stream and all that, it will be up on Orbit's channel this week. So definitely go check that out and all that. And if you're out there farming exobase, just doing some open world solo missions and everything, and you want some quiet time and all that to sit back and have a few laughs, throw us up there on your YouTube channel or on Twitch there and sit back and enjoy. Until next time, though, thanks again for all stopping by, and we will see you again next Tuesday at our regular scheduled time of 8 p.m. UK, 3 p.m. Eastern U.S. So thanks again for watching, guys, and y'all take care.
Yeah, take care.